I thought of explaining the concept of doctrine of direct effect in EU law. This is an important doctrine which was developed through case law of the Court of Justice of the European Union. What is direct effect? Direct effect means subject to conditions EU law has creates rights and obligations which individuals rely on and enforce in their national courts. Simply, the doctrine of direct effect allows EU citizens to rely on EU law against the defendant in their own national court, without the need of going to Court of Justice of the European Union. Direct effect was first identified in the case of Ganjan Enlos in 1965. It can be considered as a device introduced to protect rights of EU citizens, especially when the right of EU citizens could be better protected under EU law. If the EU law which protects rights are implemented or wrongly implemented in the national legal system, then EU citizens could rely on EU law directly and enforce their rights through the national court. We will learn facts of the Vandren case law in brief. Vandren imported some urea formaldehyde from Germany to Netherlands, and the Dutch custom authorities imposed an import tax on Vandren. Vandren argued that a tax cannot be imposed on him as per Article 12 EEC, which is now in Article 30 TFEU. As per Article 30 TFEU, member states are prohibited to impose import or export custom duties within the custom union. Court of Justice of European Union held that EU law has created a new legal order over the member states. Therefore, Vandren could rely on Article 30 TFEU in his own national courts and sue the state to protect his rights. There are two types of direct effect. They are vertical and horizontal direct effect. Vertical direct effect means a citizen relying on EU law to protect his rights against the state. Horizontal direct effect means a citizen relying on EU law to protect his rights against another individual. As it mentioned earlier, direct effect is available only if conditions are satisfied. These conditions were mentioned in the case of Vandren, and therefore we call it as Vandren criteria. They are clear and precise, unconditional, its operation must not depend on future legislation, and article must lay down a negative prohibition rather than a positive obligation. However, this fourth condition was dropped in the case of Alpha Lutic. In the case of Reyners against Belgium, CJEU confirmed that the first three are the conditions that need to be fulfilled to have a direct effect. Now we will try to apply what we learned to a problem. I have given a fictitious scenario here. Here we must see how Bob and Kathy could protect rights. Since Bob is working for a Romanian National Council, he has to go against the state. That means vertically. Kathy is working for a private company, therefore she has to go against horizontally. However, both Kathy and Bob can rely on the EU law only if Article 504 TFEU is satisfying the above stated Vandren criteria. That means Article 504 TFEU should be clear and precise, unconditional, and need not be implemented nationally to be effective.
I hope everything is clear for you now. I will be definitely meeting you with Direct Effect Part 2. It will teach you how doctrine of direct effect applies to secondary laws in EU. I thank my current student Tilaksha for helping me to narrate this video. If you enjoy my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you.